When I was pregnant with Eden, I had never painted before. I just was always drawn to watercolor. And I found a particular illustration online of three animals that look like they would live in a beautiful garden. The doe, though, in particular, had this beautiful crown of flowers, and it always was just something that just drew my eye and I could never really forget. And then after we lost her, I just still kind of symbolized Eden as the deer, as the doe. And so it was only natural that with the book she would be the main character. So the main character is a doe, and her name is Grace because our daughter's middle name was Grace. And then the story takes place in a garden, which obviously symbolizes the Garden of Eden. When I was younger, my big question was, why do bad things happen to good people? And I remember asking my elementary school teacher, and she said to me, "That's a great question. I would love to know the answer." And so it's a question that we all ask. Why do these bad things happen, especially to people that love the Lord? I want children to learn from this that bad things do happen, but that they need to literally look for Jesus. I want to teach kids that in the midst of a horrible situation, they can look and ask Jesus to become known, and that they can feel his presence, and that they can rely on him. Well, after we lost our daughter, and then now going through illustrating this book, I know the Lord as someone that's very active in my everyday life. I know him as a very present Father, in that in the middle of our tragedy, I felt his presence. I knew he was there, and he literally carried me through such a tragedy. And then the years preceding, he's always carried me and directed me and spoke to me about how to move on, how to heal, and how to see the situation. So if anything, I've just became so much closer to the Lord, and I want others to experience the nearness of the Father that I experience. Well, as a parent of a 5- and 6-year-old, I want nothing more than to know that my kids know how to depend on the Lord and look for him, and that they have an answer to why bad things happen. And so I feel like with this book, it's a tangible way to show them, like, look, this is something very bad that happened to the main character, but what did she do in this situation? And then how was the outcome? Because we watch a lot of Disney shows, or a lot of shows I grew up on, that end in a happy ending because of a spell that was reversed, a wishing on a star, whatever it is, a fairy tale ending. And that's just not reality. There's not a good ending unless you love and trust the Lord and depend on him to make the ending right.